Write the function f of x equals negative 3x squared minus 11x plus 4 in factored form. Then find the x-intercepts. Now notice that there's a negative number in front of the x squared. And when you're factoring and you have a negative number in front of the x squared, you want to take the negative out of all the terms. And for that matter, you want to see if there's a common factor for all the terms. And 3 doesn't go into 11 or 4, so I know I'm good to go just taking out the negative sign. Okay, so there you can see I took out a negative sign, which changed the sign of the rest of the terms as well. So now I'm going to factor this trinomial, or at least try to. So 3 times negative 4 is negative 12. I need to find the factors of negative 12 that add up to plus 11. And right away I'm going to go with 12 and negative 1, because I know that adds to 11 and multiplies to 12. Okay, so now I'm going to rewrite this trinomial. Just keep the negative sign out front. And I'm going to put 3x squared plus 12x minus x minus 4. Now for the first two terms, there's a 3x in common, so I'll take that out. Then x plus 4 is left over. And then for the next two terms, there's nothing really in common. Notice the x is negative, so I'm going to take out a negative 1. And then the x plus 4, that changes signs because I took out a negative sign from the negative 4. And if I were to distribute this back, negative 1 times x makes negative x. Negative 1 times 4 makes negative 4. So that would take you back to where you were in the previous step. And now I'm going to do the grouping. So the 3x and the negative 1, those go together to make a binomial. And then the x plus 4, that was in common for both. So there's our factored function. Now the next part is finding the x-intercepts. Well, let's use the zero product property for each factor. We have 3x minus 1 equals 0. Add 1 to both sides. So we get 3x equals 1 divided by 3. X equals 1/3. There's a zero. To find the other zero, x plus 4 equals 0, subtract 4, x equals negative 4. So there we have 1/3 and negative 4 as our zeros. And I like to write them in increasing order. Okay, let's take a look at what we have here. We have the factored function, which highlights the zeros, and then we went ahead and solved to figure out what those zeros were. Now, what does a zero mean in terms of the function? That's where the output equals zero, and sometimes that can be handy in problem solving.